everyone, welcome to Master to Teach step by step guide. In the previous video, you learned about the project estimation in software engineering using COCOMO model. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to identify the modes of developments for the software estimation and learn how to calculate the effort, development time, average staff size required for the software development and its productivity as well. I will try my best to explain step by step. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Let's take a sample question from the internet. The question is as follows. Using the COCOMO model, identify the project type and calculate effort, PM, development time and number of personnel required for the following use case study. Stating clarity, the assumption you have made, you may use appropriate data from the table given at the end of this question paper for the calculation. E-commerce system for Nepalese handicraft. Nepalese handicrafts are quite popular in the international market. Nepalese Handicrafts is a group of craftsmen who are looking to broaden the market of such handicraft by launching an e-commerce system, a web-based system published online where people from all over the world can buy the handicraft. You are contracted to build this system, but you haven't done these kinds of project before. You have estimated the lines of code LOC of this system to be 280 KLOC, that is thousands lines of code. The constant values A, B, C, D are as follows. Here, the first step is to identify the project type, means a mode of development, organic or semi-detached or embedded. And after identification, calculate the effort, development time, and the number of personnel required for the given software development using the same modes of development. Let's learn how to identify the project type. From this table, it's clear that which type of modes or types is best to use for the software estimation. We can identify the modes of development according to different criteria like software size, team size, etc. In questions, we are given the size of software in lines of code, which is 280,000 lines of code. So, we can identify according to the size which lies in semi-detached modes of development. Now, moving forward to calculation, we know that basic model equations as effort is equal to A multiplication of KLOC, that is thousands lines of code, to the power B, which units is person month. Development time is equal to C multiplication of effort to the power D, which units is months. Number of personnel is equal to effort divided by development time, which units is persons, where A, B, C, and D are the constants whose values for the semi-detached mode of development are as follow. A is equal to 3, B is equal to 1.12, C is equal to 2.5, and D is equal to 0.35. Therefore, in semi-detached, effort is equal to A multiplication of KLOC to the power B person month, which is equal to 3 multiplication 280 to the power 1.12 person month, which is equal to 1651.72 person month, which is near equal to or approximately 1652 person month. Development time is equal to C multiplication of effort to the power D months, which is equal to 2.5 multiplication of 1652 to the power 0.35 months. Is equal to 33.438 months, which is nearly equal to 33 months. Number of personnel is equal to effort divided by development time, which units is persons, which is equal to 1652 divided by 33 persons, which is equal to 50 persons. In this way, we can identify the modes of development to estimate the software development required effort, development time, the number of personnel, productivity, etc., which will be very helpful data for the decision making. I hope you learned from this video tutorial. If you have any questions or comments, please make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. Also, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you very much for watching. Check us out for more in IT tutorial and guide on website master2teach.com, and we will see you again soon. Bye.